Hare Krishna.
Paying respectful obeisances to my spiritual master, all glories to his divine grace, A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada.
Bhagavad Gita as it is, chapter 1, second section, verses 14 to 20, on blowing of conch shell and signs of victory. Bhagavad Gita verse 114. Tata svetair hair yukte mahati syandane sthitau madava pandavaschaiva divyau syankhau pradathmatu. Word meanings. Tata, thereafter, svetai, with white, hey, horses, yukte, being yoked, mahati, in a great, syandane, chariot, sthitau, situated, madava, Kṛṣṇa, the master of the goddess of fortune, pandava, Arjuna, the son of Pandu, cha, also, eva, certainly, divyau, transcendental, syankhau, conchshells, pradathmatu, sounded. Translation by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada. On the other side, both Lord Kṛṣṇa and Arjuna, stationed on a great chariot drawn by white horses, sounded their transcendental conchshells. Bhakti Vedanta purport. In contrast with the conch shell blown by Bhishma Deva, the conch shells in the hands of Kṛṣṇa and Arjuna are described as transcendental. The sounding of the transcendental conch shells indicated that there was no hope of victory for the other side because Kṛṣṇa was on the side of the Pandavas. Jayastu Pandu Putranam Yesham Pakshe Janardana. Victory is always with persons like the sons of Pandu because Lord Kṛṣṇa is associated with them, and whenever and wherever the Lord is present, the goddess of fortune is also there because the goddess of fortune never lives alone without her husband. Therefore, victory and fortune were awaiting Arjuna as indicated by the transcendental sound produced by the conch shell of Vishnu or Lord Kṛṣṇa. Besides that, the chariot on which both the friends were seated had been donated by Agni, the fire god, to Arjuna, and this indicated that this chariot was capable of conquering all sides wherever it was drawn over the three worlds. Bhagavad Gita verse 115. Panchajanyam hṛṣīkeśo devadattam dananjaya paundram dadmau mahāsaṅkham bhīma karma vrikodara. Word meanings. Panchajanyam, the conch shell named Panchajanya, Rishikesho, Hṛṣīkeśa, Kṛṣṇa, the Lord who directs the senses of the devotees. Devadattam, the conch shell named Devadatta. Dhananjaya, Dhananjaya, Arjuna, the winner of wealth. Paundram, the conch shell named Paundra. Dadmau, blue. Mahashankham, the terrific conch shell. Bhima Karma, one who performs Herculean tasks. Vrikavdara, the voracious eater. Bhima. Translation by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada. Lord Kṛṣṇa blew his conch shell called Panchajanya, Arjuna blew his the Devadatta, and Bhima, the voracious eater and performer of Herculean tasks, blew his terrific conch shell called Paundra. Bhakti Vedanta purport. Lord Kṛṣṇa is referred to as Hṛṣīkeśa in this verse because he is the owner of all senses. The living entities are part and parcel of him, and therefore the senses of the living entities are also part and parcel of his senses. The impersonalists cannot account for the senses of the living entities, and therefore they are always anxious to describe all living entities as senseless or impersonal. The Lord situated in the hearts of all living entities directs their senses, but he directs in terms of the surrender of the living entity, and in the case of a pure devotee, he directly controls the senses. Here on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, the Lord directly controls the transcendental senses of Arjuna, and thus his particular name of Hṛṣīkeśa. The Lord has different names according to his different activities. For example, his name is Madhusudana because he killed the demon of the name Madhu. His name is Govinda because he gives pleasure to the cows and to the senses. His name is Vasudeva because he appeared as the son of Vasudeva. His name is Devaki Nandana because he accepted Devaki as his mother. His name is Yashoda Nandana because he awarded his childhood pastimes to Yashoda at Vrindavana. His name is Partha Sarathi because he worked as charioteer of his friend Arjuna. Similarly, his name is Hṛṣīkeśa because he gave direction to Arjuna on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Arjuna is referred to as Dhananjaya in this verse because he helped his elder brother in fetching wealth when it was required by the king to make expenditures for different sacrifices. Similarly, Bhima is known as Vrikodara because he could eat as voraciously as he could perform Herculean tasks such as killing the demon Hidimba. So, the particular types of conchshell blown by the different personalities on the side of the Pandavas beginning with the lords were all very encouraging to the fighting soldiers. On the other hand, there were no such credits nor the presence of Lord Kṛṣṇa, the supreme director, nor that of the goddess of fortune. So, they were predestined to lose the battle, and that was the message announced by the sounds of the conchshells. Bhagavad Gita verse 1.16. अनंत विजयम राजा कुंती पुत्रो युधिष्ठिर नकुल सहदेवश्च सुघोष मणिपुष्पकौ. Word meanings: Ananta Vijayam, the conchshell named Ananta Vijaya, Raja, the king, Kunti Putra, the son of Kunti, Yudhishthira, Yudhishthir, Nakula, Nakul, Sahadeva, Sahadeva, Cha, and Sughosha Manipushpaka, the conchshells named Sughosha and Manipushpaka. Translation by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. King Yudhishthira, the son of Kunti, blew his conchshell, the Ananta Vijaya, and Nakula and Sahadeva blew the Sughosha and Manipushpaka. Discovering key points from the three verses. How did Lord Kṛṣṇa make his first appearance in the Bhagavad Gita? What is the significance of Krishna's name Hṛṣīkeśa? Mahati syandane. Why is the chariot of Arjuna great? Divyau śaṅkhau. Why are the conchshells of Kṛṣṇa and Arjuna mentioned as transcendental? What are the learnings from these verses and how do we apply the learnings? Lord Krishna's first appearance. Lord Sri Krishna appeared as chariot driver, Sarathi, of Arjuna's great chariot. He appeared in his two-handed transcendental form. He was called for the first time in Bhagavad Gita as Madhava by Sanjaya, attendant of King Dhritarashtra of Hastinapura, erstwhile Delhi, who could see the events of the great Kurukshetra war with divine eyes. While driving Arjuna's chariot, he possessed his transcendental conchshell named Panchajanya with himself. As per discourse by Srila Prabhupada in London 1973 on Lord Krishna's divine name, Hṛṣīkeśa. Lord Kṛṣṇa is referred to as Hṛṣīkeśa because he is the owner of all senses, master of the senses. Hṛṣīka means sense and Isha means owner. So, he is the lord of the senses. The gross body consists of the senses. The living entities are part and parcel of him and therefore the senses of the living entities are also part and parcel of his senses. He is the original controller of the senses. Just as the king is the original controller of all the activities of the state. According to Vedic civilization, after the birth of a child, there is a name-giving ceremony. What kind of name he should be given was calculated astrologically because the name should carry some indication of the activities of his future life. So here Krishna is named Hṛṣīkeśa. Arjuna's great chariot. Arjuna's great chariot was gifted by Agni Deva, god of fire. This was designed and built by Vishwakarma, architect of the demigods. This was yoked with white horses named Saibhya, Sugriva, Meghapushpa, and Balahaka, and had a flag with a picture of Hanuman. To please Agni Deva, Lord Kṛṣṇa had arranged to offer him the Khandava forest. The Lord asked Arjuna to guard Agni Deva while the forest was being burned down and accompanied him as his charioteer. Agni Deva was so satisfied with the offering that he presented Arjuna with the Gandiva bow, a team of horses, a chariot, two inexhaustible quivers, and armor. Transcendental Conchshell. Lord Kṛṣṇa blew his transcendental conchshell, divyau śaṅkhau called Panchajanya. The śaṅkha used by the Lord was not ordinary. After shifting to Mathura, arrangements were made for Lord Kṛṣṇa and Balarama to live under the instructions of their spiritual master, Sandipani Muni, in his ashram in northern India, today's Ujjain. In return for the learning received, they seek to serve their teacher with some offering or Guru Dakshina. Sandipani Muni asked for the return of his dead son, who had drowned in the ocean on the bank of Kurukshetra near today's Somnath in Gujarat. Kṛṣṇa and Balarama immediately went to the beach and asked the controlling deity of the ocean to return the son of their teacher. The ocean deity informed the Lord that the boy was captured by a demon named Panchajana, who generally remained deep in the water in the shape of a conchshell. Kṛṣṇa dove deep into the water, caught hold of the demon Panchajana, killed him on the spot, but could not find the son of his teacher within his belly. He returned with the body of the demon shaped as a conchshell. Thereafter, he along with his elder brother Balarama went to Samyamani, the residence of Yamaraj, and blew his conchshell Panchajanya. Yamaraj received his master with all respectful obeisance and returned the teacher's son. Arjuna blew the conchshell called Devadatta. Arjuna saved Maya Danav from the Khandava forest fire, and Maya Danav, the master of illusions and well-known architect, constructed an extraordinary assembly hall, Maya Sabha, at Indraprastha near today's Delhi, as the capital seat of the Pandavas. Maya Danav had found the conchshell Devadatta from Bindu Sarovar to the east of Mount Kailash and also gifted the same to Arjuna. The sound of the conchshell could break the heart of any opponent as per Mahabharata. Srila Prabhupada in his discourse offered the following learning. By using the word divyau śaṅkhau, Sanjaya very tactfully informed King Dhritarashtra that the signs already clearly indicated that the whole Kuru dynasty would be killed in that great battle, and his unlawful policy to deceive the Pandavas wasn't very laudable. The whole catastrophe was due to King Dhritarashtra because he encouraged the policy followed by his sons.
In verse 1.2, Sanjaya called Duryodhana as Raja, the king, to indicate the desire of Dhritarashtra to have his own eldest son as successor of Kuru dynasty. In verse 1.16, Sanjaya called Yudhishthira as Raja to indicate that the eldest son of Pandu was the rightful heir of the Kuru dynasty and the outcome of the war would be in favor of the Pandavas as per the desire of Lord Kṛṣṇa.
Hare Kṛṣṇa, you can press the like button, you can share the video, provide feedback through comments, even ask questions, subscribe to the channel, check the other videos and look forward to more such videos. You can press the bell icon for notifications. Hare Kṛṣṇa.